Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back. I'm really looking forward to this project today because in this video, we get to play with sand. Now back when I made my first mini metal foundry and used it to melt down soda cans, I was looking for the most convenient and easy ways to cast that metal. You've seen the styrofoam casting method where we make the object out of styrofoam and bury it in a bucket of sand, but the problem is the styrofoam object always gets destroyed. I followed up by trying to make some plaster molds, but we found the plaster cracks. So in this video, we're trying a method that I've actually wanted to try for years, and that's greensand casting. Now, a lot of you watching have probably seen videos on greensand casting or maybe even tried it yourself. But because of all my projects, experiments, and production, I haven't found the time to play with it myself. So that's what we're doing today. The purpose of this video is to make some high quality greensand for metal casting. Let's get started. Now, the materials we're gonna be using to making our sand are very simple. I just went down to local Home Depot and picked up this 50 pound bag of play sand. That was only about $3.50. Then I went down to Walmart and picked up this bag of unscented kitty litter for about $1.50. Aside from those, we're just gonna need a scale and a spray bottle of water. When it comes to casting your metals, the finer the material is that you cast into, the cleaner your result is gonna be. So we really want the finest sand and the finest clay that we can get. Unfortunately, with play sand like this, you can see that it's not that fine. And the kitty litter we've got is bentonite clay, but you can see it comes in all kinds of clumps. So the first thing we need to do to prepare our materials is screen our sand and crush our kitty litter. Now while I was down at the Super Center, I picked up a couple of different options in strainers, and while I would love to use the large one because it'd be quicker, if you look at the mesh here, you can see the holes are a little bit wider. That's gonna allow larger grains of sand to fall through, and what we really want is a fine mesh, like this 3-inch strainer. If you look at the mesh on this, you can see that only very fine grains of sand are gonna be able to get through, and that's really what we want, even though it's gonna take a lot longer. So step number one, grab some sand, grab your strainer, and get sifting. Hey guys, I am back from straining my sand and check out what I've done here. I actually used both sets of strainers. I used the larger one first to speed up the process and get the big chunks out. Then I took the strained pieces of sand and ran it through this 3-inch strainer to get even finer sand. And here are our results. When we pour these four samples we've collected out on a plate, you can really see the difference. This first pile here is the regular sand straight from the bag. The pile over here on the far right is the stuff we strained off using our larger strainer. The next pile is the stuff we strained off using the 3-inch strainer. This last pile here is the stuff that was left over, and you can see it's extremely fine sand. Everything else has been filtered off and only the smallest particles remain, and you can definitely see that when you compare it to the other piles. Now, depending on the mesh of your strainers, you could actually get your sand so fine it would almost be like a powder. But of course, you're gonna have to invest some time into the process. Now, I found an even quicker and easier way to get this done is just go down to your local pet store and pick up a bag of aquarium sand. This stuff is already super fine and really well sifted. It's gonna cost you about $8 a bag, but that's well worth your time. In fact, these particles of sand are so small, it's even finer than the stuff we just made ourselves. But I'm gonna put both of them to the test. Now the next step is to pulverize our kitty litter, and we could do that in a couple of different ways. We could pour it into a blender and grind it up, or we could just stick it in a freezer bag and pound it with a mallet. In either case, once we've got it all crushed up, we are gonna need to filter that, but we're not gonna need to do nearly as much. When we mix these things together, we're gonna use a ratio of about 95% sand and only 5 to 10% clay, so we're not gonna need much. The stuff that comes out of the blender is really, really fine. It's almost like powder, but remember, this stuff is gonna wreck your blades, so make sure it's a blender you don't care too much about. So here we are guys, we've got our clay pulverized and sifted to a point where it has a consistency of powdered sugar. Over here we have our hand sifted sand, and over here we have our aquarium sand, so now all we have to do is mix them together in a ratio of about 95% sand and 5 to 10% clay. And we're gonna measure them by weight using a scale. So update guys, I went ahead and measured out all the different ingredients here. We've got our aquarium sand and we've got our hand sifted sand here. I've got 475 grams in each of these cups. Now to make this a 95-5 ratio, I also measured out 25 grams of clay into each of these cups. What we have to do now is pour in the clay and mix these up thoroughly. There are a lot of different ways you could mix this stuff together. You could throw it in a blender, stir it with a stick, or even just grab a couple of cups and pour it back a few times until everything looks thoroughly constituted. So here we are, we've got our two sample size batches thoroughly mixed and ready to go. All that's left to do now is add a little water. Now the key to making really good green sand is we want it to be moist, but we do not want it to be wet. I think the easiest way to do this is just take our sand and gently spread it out on something like a plate to expose more surface area. Then using a spray water bottle, we'll adjust the nozzle so it has a fine spray and we'll just gently mist the top of the sand. When you spray a little water, you're gonna notice the sand changes color. And when it does, you wanna go ahead and just thoroughly mix that in until all the color disappears. Go ahead and keep doing this until your sand gets to the consistency where you think it'll be great for making sand castles. Now I've sprayed a fair amount of water here to the point where the sand doesn't change color anymore and I've mixed it thoroughly. But you can see when I grab a handful now and squeeze it, when I let it go, it just cracks and crumbles apart. And that probably means we don't have enough clay. So at this point, we can start mixing together a little bit more clay and mix it in thoroughly until it gets to the point where we can squeeze it firmly and have it all hold together. Quick update guys, I went ahead and added more clay powder to this mixture and now it's somewhere between 15 to 20% of the total composition. And now the sand has reached the consistency where if I grab it and squeeze it in my hand, you can see it leaves a little clump, and if we take that clump, it's nice and firm, but if we give it a little snap, it breaks cleanly right down the center. And I believe that's what we're looking for. So the recipe I had was 5% clay, but it seems 15 to 20% clay works a little bit better with the clay sand that I'm using here. Let's see how that compares to the aquarium sand. So check this out guys, I've just mixed up our aquarium sand, and this time I only used 10% clay, but if we do a stop check, you can see it balls up in my hand just as nicely as we'd hope it would. And if we crack it down the center, we got a nice clean break. I think this stuff is done with 10% clay, and I think it's attributed to the moisture content. It's a very fine balance though, because you don't want this stuff dripping wet. So guys, it looks like our green sand experiment was a success in both the aquarium sand and the play sand. The only real difference I've noticed between the two is how much time you want to spend sifting it out. Okay, let's recap. We started off our experiment today with a full bag of play sand and found we could use different size strainers to get the finest sand possible. Next, we crushed up some unscented kitty litter, bentonite clay, until it was a fine powder to match the mesh of our sand. We mixed them together in a ratio of 95% sand, 5% clay, and found that that wasn't enough to make them stick together. So we added more clay until it was closer to 15%. The clay seems to be the glue that holds the whole composition together, and the water is the ingredient that activates it. So we added a mist of water one squirt at a time until the sand reached a consistency where we could squeeze it in our hand and form a clump that would hold its shape. We could tell the sand was ready by holding the clump between two fingers and giving it a little tug. A clean break right down the center indicates the sand is ready to use. So now that we've got our two sample batches, I think from here on out I'm using aquarium sand because it's a lot quicker and more convenient to use. So how is our freshly made green sand going to hold up to actual metal casting? Well, I'm going to make up a whole big batch of this stuff, store it in an airtight container, and we'll test it tomorrow. Thanks for joining me for this experiment, guys. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. Whoa. It came out faster than I was expecting. Hey guys, thanks for watching, and remember, I'm giving away prizes now on every new video. All you have to do to qualify is subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and select to be notified when my next videos get released. The secret link to my giveaways will be pinned in the comments for the first 12 hours. If you like what I'm doing, show your support right now by giving this video a big thumbs up and share with a friend. I love you back, and I'll see you next time.